Hello, 3D printing friends. Today on the BV3D channel, we'll get a look at this sweet 3D printed bit of machinery. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hi, welcome back. This episode is sponsored by PCBWay. More about them in just a bit. Okay, so today I want to show you this mechanical marvel by Miklos, Kiszely. This is a beautiful piece of engineering with herringbone gears, worm gears, and rack and pinion steering, and you'll get to see it in action in just a minute. It's glorious. Okay, so one of the issues with the Bamboo Lab Automatic Material System, or AMS, is that it's not compatible with every single filament spool currently in production on planet Earth. It's compatible with a lot of them, don't get me wrong, but not all of them. For example, several filament manufacturers have switched to using cardboard spools in response to a community push for more eco-friendly packaging. And for the record, I'm happy they've done that. But Bamboo Lab cautions that cardboard dust could build up in the AMS and cause issues. Despite this, I and many other people have been using filament with cardboard spools in our AMS units anyway. But sometimes the AMS can't rewind the spools properly. It can't get a grip on the outer edge of the spool to roll it back. Sometimes you can solve that problem by printing a thin plastic rim that you can just snap onto those spools. And that works great and can sometimes even help cardboard spools that have a slightly damaged rim. With cardboard spools used by Polymaker, I found a really clever hack for those. Now, not everybody knows this, but the Bamboo Lab spools are refillable. Give them a twist to unlock them, and you can load in a refill. So with the Polymaker cardboard spools, you can rip the sides off and mount the filament, cardboard hub and all, in a standard Bamboo Lab spool. But sometimes the problem with the spool isn't that it's made out of cardboard. Sometimes the spool is bent or broken or otherwise damaged. And sometimes the problem is that it's just too big to fit in the AMS. Maybe it's too wide, or maybe it's too tall, or maybe it's both. I run into that with Jesse filament spools from Printed Solid. Their plastic spools were a little bit too big to fit, and when they switched to cardboard spools, which are really nicely done, by the way, those were the same dimensions as the plastic ones. So those won't fit in the AMS either. So how do we solve that problem? Find out right after this. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. PCBWay is known for making low-cost, high-quality printed circuit boards, but they also do CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, and even injection molding. Using PCBWay is easy. Just upload your PCB files or 3D models, select from the wide range of materials, colors, and options, and place your order. They sent me a few samples, and I gotta say, these circuit board rulers and coasters are freaking amazing. And the clear resin prints of the PCBWay logo? These are 100% crystal clear. So whether you need PCBs, machining services, or even something printed in a specialty material your printer can't handle, PCBWay can do that for you. Check them out at PCBWay.com. There's a coupon code in the description, so be sure to check that out too. And now, back to the video. So I have a lot of printed solid Jesse filament, and those spools won't fit in the AMS. And I have a lot of protopasta filament, which also comes on cardboard spools that don't easily fit the AMS. But thanks to Miklos Kiszely's Bamboo Lab P1/X1/X1C/X1CC filament spool switcher and winder if you use AMS, boy, that's a mouthful, I can now use it in all my AMS units. Here, I'll transfer a new 500 gram spool of protopasta so you can see it in action. There's a printable donor spool holder included in the files, but I already had this one, so that's what I'll use. With the protopasta on the spool holder, feed the filament through the guide tube and then load an empty Bamboo Lab spool on the winder. I did drill a small hole near the edge of the hub on the Bamboo Lab spool just so I'd have a place to anchor the incoming filament, so I'll get that hooked in there. And then it's just a matter of cranking this handle to get the filament transferred from the protopasta spool to the bamboo spool. A very clever mechanism guides the filament back and forth to help ensure even winding from side to side on the bamboo spool. Doing this by hand only takes a few minutes, and you can speed it up even more by using the included drill adapter. But I don't mind doing it by hand. If you want to build this, you'll need to print out the parts, of course, and you'll also need a short length of PTFE tubing to use as a guide tube, and you'll need 4 M3x6 screws and 7 608 bearings. Those are the bearings commonly used on skateboards and in fidget spinners. As a convenience, there's a link to those in the description. Miklos has some excellent assembly, usage, and troubleshooting videos on the model's printables page, so if you're running into issues, they've got you covered. And by the way, you can re-spool onto any plastic spool that fits in the AMS. You don't have to use a bamboo spool, I'm just using that because I have them and I know they work. The one I just did is Protopasta Nebula Multicolor. I've also re-spooled some Protopasta Nebula Silk Silver, some Jesse Neon Green, and some Purple Ice. And of course, this is also a great way to transfer filament from a broken or damaged spool to a good one, no matter what printer you use. So I have to say, I love this design, and I love, love, love these gears. To me, regular gears are cool, but these herringbone gears are like next level. And that mechanism that moves the guide tube is genius. I previously did some preliminary work on designing a motorized respooler and using a servo-controlled mechanism to move a guide tube, but this thing doesn't need any electronics. It's purely mechanical. Anyway, please go check out Miklos' model on printables. There's a link in the description. And if you print it, post a make there. As always, big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether through channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing so you don't miss future episodes. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this episode. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.